We are now joined on stage by our Master of Ceremonies, Reverend Mariama White Hammond.
Voices heard, but there is more than one way to do that. And there is power, not just in being loud, but also power in silence. I want to acknowledge the presence of many people for whom making loud noise may not necessarily be the best way to express. And particularly, we are excited to have so many members of the deaf community here. And so, thank you. We want to follow their lead and speak with our hands together. We also acknowledge that there are those who struggle with anxiety and folks who are autistic for whom loud noises are a challenge. But that doesn't mean they are unable to connect. And so, we want to take a moment for you to lock eyes with someone you don't know. Lock eyes with someone you don't know. And with your eyes, I want you to say three things. Don't, not with your mouth, with your eyes. I see you. I stand with you. And we stand together. I now have the pleasure to invite to the stage Claudia and Savannah Fox, who are First Nations people of Arawak descent. Claudia Foxtree is a professional educator who leads conversations on Native American identity, culture, and history. And she is affiliated with the Mass Center for Native American Awareness and the United Confederation of Taino People. Her daughter, Savannah, is a sophomore architecture major at Roger Williams University. And she will be singing Amazing Grace first in Cherokee and then in English.
Thank you to the Wampanoag, the Nipmuc, and the Narragansett who originally inhabited this land we know as Massachusetts. Welcome to everyone else. All summer and fall, I and others have been standing in solidarity with the water protectors at Standing Rock in North Dakota. Without water, we have no life. Today I stand in solidarity with my sisters from Boston and around the world in places such as Sydney, Tokyo, Singapore, Nairobi, Athens, Cape Town, Rio de Janeiro, San Jose, and Vancouver. With solidarity, we have hope. We are the few who have the privilege to be here because we can afford not to be working on a Saturday. We are healthy and today's event is accessible to us. And we have help for children who may have been left at home. We stand beside those who ask for things like equal pay, disability awareness, health care, and child care. Ancestors greeted Christopher Columbus. We have been fighting attempted genocide, intolerance, hate, lies about our people, lack of recognition for our achievements and contributions, racist mascot representations in media and sports, and acts of violence for over 500 years. We are the original survivors of this land. Standing up is in our blood. Today we are reminded that our struggle is not over. It is part of what makes us women, humans, and survivors. We are stronger when we stand together as allies, activists, agitators, and accomplices. As our ally James Baldwin once said, not everything that is faced can be changed, but nothing can be changed until it is faced. Today we begin to face the challenge of keeping our hard-won rights and creating more equity for those who are marginalized and still fighting. In our Indigenous community, women are often the ones who keep the culture alive. We pass on traditions to our daughters and our sons, as well as through our unique community ties. We lead by example. We stand up for the environment, humanity, and other sentient beings with whom we share Turtle Island. Two of my three daughters could not be here. My oldest, Cheyenne, has devoted her career to doing social justice work and activism. She's completing a master's in social work at Salem State University. But right now, she's in Washington, D.C. My youngest, who's a twin, Indigo, is at Framingham State University, where she does activism through student leadership and in her artwork. I myself am a product of the University of Massachusetts, Boston, and Fitchburg State College. Massachusetts is fortunate to have free K-12 public education system and a fabulous state universities that need to remain open and accessible to all. I am elated to be here and to have my other twin daughter, Savannah, standing by my side. She is going to sing a song that represents the ability to change even in the darkest times. Amazing Grace. First in Cherokee and then in English, at which point all will be asked to join and sing the first verse with her.
Is unbelievable. It's great. It makes us feel good. We need to amplify up all our voices. But it's not what we do today that's important. It's what we do tomorrow. That's what we have to do. We have to harness this energy that's here today. And we have to organize our neighborhoods. We have to organize women in the workplace to let them know that we're not going backwards, we're going forwards. Massachusetts has the proud distinction of being the first state in the country for so many things. And in 2004, we brought to this state universal health care to make sure that our residents would have the health care that they deserve. We didn't go bankrupt over that. We ran a program that worked. In 2010, after the Supreme Judicial Court came down, on marriage equality. In Massachusetts, we protected marriage equality. We were the first state in the country to do that. And we are going to be the first state in the country to fight back on Washington when they start to go after different things that affect so many different people. We're going to stand up. We will fight. We will take this fight from Boston Common to the Mall in Washington to let the president know that he's supposed to represent all of us. He doesn't have to make America great again. America is great. It's the greatest country in the world, and because of all of us. Now say it with me. Are we going to amplify?
Yeah.
Are we going to fight?
Yeah.
Are we going to organize?
Yeah.
And we will never be defeated.
Yes!
Now, I have the great honor of introducing our champion in the United States Senate, a fighter who always is in our corner, United States Senator Elizabeth Warren.
And hello, friends of women of Massachusetts. I love you too. Thank you, Mayor Walsh. I am glad to have this chance to stand shoulder to shoulder to fight alongside the mayor of Boston for the people of this country. Thank you. So, we're here today because of the power of women. The power of women to come up with good ideas like this rally. The power of women to organize like this rally. And the power of women to make sure that as our country enters a new political era, that the voices of the people will be heard. Yesterday, Donald Trump was sworn in as president. That sight is now burned into my eyes forever. And I hope the same is true for you. Because we will not forget. We do not want to forget. We will use that vision to make sure that we fight harder, we fight tougher, and we fight more passionately for than ever. Not just for the people whom Donald Trump supports, but for all of America. Trump's campaign was about attacks on women, attacks on African Americans, attacks on Latinos, attacks on religious groups, attacks on immigrants. A Trump-Pence Supreme Court could overturn Roe versus Wade and dissolve marriages of LGBTQ citizens. A Republican Congress is eager to rip away health care from millions of Americans. America's hard-working families have taken one punch after another. Decades of trickle-down economics and attacks on unions, attacks on wages, attacks on pensions, attacks on health care, attacks on Social Security, attacks on education, attacks on infrastructure and financial regulation have gutted America's middle class. A broken criminal justice system, a broken voting rights system, and decades of systematic racism have kept people of color from having the same opportunities as other Americans throughout this country. The is that the playing field has been tilted badly in favor of those at the top for a generation now. And now, President Trump and the Republican Congress are ready to ram through laws that will tilt it even harder. Now, we can whimper, we can whine, or we can fight back. Me, I'm here to fight back. I'm here to fight back. And that is why we come together today. Hundreds of thousands of people in Boston, in Washington, and across this country, we are in marches to say we are fighting back. That's who we are. We come here to stand shoulder to shoulder, to make clear we are here, we will not be silent, we will not play dead, we will fight for what we believe in. Yeah! We have a vision, and that vision defines who we are as a people. First, we fight for basic dignity and respect for every human being, period. No compromise, no backing up. And second, we fight for economic opportunity, not just for those at the top, but for everyone. All of our kids deserve a fighting chance to get ahead. Respect for everyone, economic opportunity for everyone. That is the American deal, and that's what we fight for. Now, those core principles call out the best in who we are. For too long, American families have seen a government and an economy that isn't working for them. And Trump and the Republicans promised to make America worse. But we're here because we are ready to fight for the people who want to build a country that works for all of us. That's why we're here. We come together to give each other strength. We come together to give each other courage. We come together to remind each other of our values. As we get ready to march, let us remind each other what we believe in and why we fight and why we will keep right on fighting. We believe that no one in this country should work full time and live in poverty, and that means raising the minimum wage. Yes, it does. Paid overtime, sick leave, we will fight for it. We believe that workers have a right to come together and to bargain together. Unions built America's middle class, and unions will rebuild America's middle class. We believe that every young person is entitled to get an education without getting crushed by student loan debt. We believe in debt. Say something that is really controversial in some places in Washington. We believe in science. Yeah. We know that climate change is real, and we have a moral responsibility to protect this earth for our children and our believe that immigration makes us a stronger country. We will not build a stupid wall, and we will not tear millions of families apart, not on our watch. believe that sexism, racism, homophobia, and bigotry have no place in this country. Black lives matter. Diversity makes our country stronger. We believe that equal means equal. And that's true in the workplace, it's true in marriage, it's true every place. We will never stop fighting to ensure equality for all of our citizens. You know, I could do this all day. That I cannot believe I have to do in 2017. We believe in equal pay for equal work and a woman's right to decisions over her own body. Yes. This is what we believe. This is what we will fight for. This is what we will march for. Are you ready to fight? Are you ready to make sure today and tomorrow and the next day and the day after that our voices are heard?